And one thing we often don't know is that there are many parts of India where more than half the babies born don't have a birth certificate. You know, if you go to, because the local registration does not happen, babies are born at home or they can't afford to pay the bribe to get the birth certificate. A lot of problems. And so we have literally millions of people, not just 10%, I would say 30-40%, who don't have this identity. So we have done a number of things for this purpose. We have a concept called an introducer. So if somebody does not have any ID whatsoever, then somebody else who could be an NGO or a government employee can introduce that person and say, I know this person and this is the name that they have. And because our ID is a unique ID, you had only one ID in our system, we can be fairly sure that that person will use the right name for that thing. So using the introducer, we make sure that people with no ID get an ID. Similarly, we have a special program for the homeless. We give an address, care of a shelter, urban shelter or care of an NGO. If you look at our database, you can even have an address near the flyover, under the flyover. So, you know, in India, you have to be very innovative on these things. So we've done a lot of things specifically for inclusion. And in fact, our biggest sort of customers, if you want to call it, people who come to us are really the poor who need desperately need an ID for their future.
I see this all the time because when I try to go for a walk, I walk on the road because there's no pedestrian walkway. Or I go to the, you know, the parks here. So I think the it's really about better enforcement, and it's not clear to me what is the systemic solution for that. As I said, part of our challenge in India is our cities are underpowered, and we really need to upgrade the city's internal capability before we can do these things better. But that's one of the things that I'd like to take up. As regards the issue of the Congress, you know, I mean, notwithstanding the 10 years of what's of rule, I think in my particular case, they gave me the opportunity to do what I've done, right? So they invited me to form the UIDAI. And I can say with full honesty that they have given me complete support to do all the reforms that we have done. And these reforms have hugely benefited the people. As I said, giving 500 million people an identity, giving them direct cash transfers, giving them financial inclusion, giving subsidy reforms. And nobody has come in the way of that and has been fully supportive. So my personal experience is that there is tremendous commitment to improving systems and eliminating corruption from the society. So I feel that I should be part of that. All political parties in India will go through major change in the next 10 years. And I think you're going to find fairly dramatic changes happening in terms of how candidates are selected, how inner party democracy works, how monies are raised. All this is going to go through. We're in a state of a churn. And I think I can play a huge role in that churn and make a difference, which is why I chose what I did. X is the Prime Minister or Y is the Prime Minister, not going to be relevant to you and me in Bangalore, right? It's really a high-level thing. But right now, we need someone who is a champion for Bangalore, who is an ambassador for Bangalore, who will work with all the various agencies around India and around the world for improving Bangalore. And I think that is the role that I would like to play. And frankly, that role can be played whether you're part of the ruling government or you're in the opposition. So I think it's about if you have the networks, if you have the credibility, you have the stature, then you can, you know, work, negotiate in the system to get what you want for the city. I really want to understand what's on people's mind, which is why I'm meeting people from all walks of life. The top concerns for the middle class and elite is about transportation and pavements and so forth. But when I meet young kids from slum areas, their top concern is jobs. They're saying that we're not getting enough jobs. So I think we have to sort of go through the entire gamut of concerns of people from different backgrounds. But my fundamental sense is we definitely need to improve on the infrastructure, whether it's about better public transportation, better water and so forth. And very importantly, I'm finding from my talking to young people is they want a better platform for job creation and job growth, which again, nobody has really paid attention to that. And I think my experience of having founded a company, Infosys was an idea which became, you know, 48,000 crore revenue, has taught me that there is a way you can create an environment and a platform for job creation and for skilling people for those jobs. What we have learned in the last 10 years is in India, we have made a significant increase in spending on education. Never before has India spent so much money on education. And the success story has been enrollments have gone up. So more and more kids are in school. What has not happened is learning outcomes have not improved. If you see the latest ASSA report which came out 2 days back, learning outcomes are actually declining. So I think now the challenge is not
more schools or more classrooms or more attendance. It's about how to improve the learning outcomes. And that's an area where I do hope to participate in. And there are many, many interesting things happening in that area, but we still haven't got to the bottom of how to improve learning outcomes. And that's the area that I would like to focus on. We are trying to see how do we create a collaborative platform where everybody can give ideas, everybody can have a sense of participation, and everybody who wants to contribute can contribute to Bangalore's improvement in whatever way they want, because somebody has a lot of time to give, somebody has little time, somebody has certain skills. In some sense, we did that in the BATF, but I realized that that was just a few people. Is there a way to open this up and create a platform of collaboration where everybody can input into, everybody can contribute, everybody can feel that not only there's a problem, but they're part of the solution. And that's something which I hope to do. In fact, what I'm excited by is there a way to think about getting our cities moving, like getting Bangalore moving, leveraging and getting the energy of the people into that? And how do we create a system for doing that? That's really what I hope to do. It's not that Bangalore is just a stepping stone where I go off and do something else. That wouldn't be fair. So I definitely will, if it happens, I will definitely spend significant amount of my time, mind space and energy on Bangalore. Now, will I do other things? That depends on a lot of other factors. I can't say what that will be, but I can be very clear that making Bangalore better is one of my prime goals, whatever I'm doing in the future. There are many facets to the water issue. One is, of course, reducing water wastage in our distribution, which is quite high. The second is recycling water. The third is improving the quality of our groundwater and raising the groundwater levels. The fourth is recovering our lakes, which are really have been great, the reservoirs of water for the city, and we have lost a lot of our lakes. Half our lakes have become, apartment complex and all that. So we need to fix that. And we need to obviously look at what are the issues of getting water all the way from the Kaveri. So I think water has many, many dimensions to it, but we have to try to find a way to reuse and recycle and restore water in our own world. I mean, Bangalore is 3,000 feet above sea level. So you're spending a huge amount of energy pumping up water from the Kaveri to Bangalore. Is there a better way to do this by leveraging Bangalore's own assets? I guess my approach to solving problems is different from Arvind Kejriwal's approach to solving problems. I believe that you solve problems by getting deep into the thing, by looking at all the stakeholders, by trying to fashion a sustainable solution. And so I think, are there challenges with the police? Yes, of course, there are probably challenges with the police. But we have to find a way to, but they are there. They're the first line of security. They're the first line of defense. We have to look at what is it that we need to do to improve their functioning, and just blaming them is not going to solve the problem. So my approach in general is a constructive problem-solving approach to solving problems. It's not something which can be done in a day. It's the stuff that takes over time. And I will bring that approach even to the issues of security. I think India needs large-scale change. That large-scale change is only possible through a political process. You can't do it from outside. You can't do it from as a technocrat, you can't do it as an NGO, you can't do it as an activist. You have to get into the system to improve it. That change will take time, and it's a change which has to be done through really working the system. So my only motivation to do what I do is to bring change. If I'm not able to bring change, let me tell you, I will not be doing it. The fact is that unless we change our politics, we can't change the country. It's as simple as that. We can avoid the problem, we can work around the problem, but we can't really solve it. So I think if we can make it, open it up for new people to come in, if the process of selection is transparent, if the process of funding is transparent, if the process of election campaigning is transparent, then automatically it will get opened up. So it goes back to having systemic solutions for that. One of the things I've done in the last few days is actually visit many colleges. I spoke at Rice University, I'm speaking at Jyoti Niwas College, I spoke at Jain University. I think the trick is how do we find the model of engagement for them, because they have their own preoccupations. They want to finish their studies, they want to get a job, but they have some interest to do something. So we have to find a way for them to come in and do that. Just like we talked about how do we get citizens to participate, it's about creating a way for them to participate, and definitely we have to tap into that energy also.